tried it, but...
Maybe they could play it better. We'll have to see. M2KC, they're going to be leading with Jamili on the Arcane Mage, Roasties on the Assassination Rogue, and Rub Cub on that Restoration Druid. Never lucky once again. They're going to be locking in the Demon Hunter, Death Knight, Resto Druid. The last time these two teams met, this was the matchup I believe we saw, and it went in favor of Never Lucky 3-0. We'll have to see how practiced Zach is on that Demon Hunter. He just played a series as the Holy Paladin. And I think that's one of the things that's so impressive about Never Lucky, is you just had Cole play Assassination Rogue. Now he's the Restoration Druid. You had Zach playing the Holy Paladin. Now he's the Demon Hunter. It just shows the versatility of these players.
Yeah, a lot of versatility on the side of Never Lucky. Both of these teams defeated Cloud9, an impressive feat in and itself, our current spring champions, and now they go head-to-head to have a go at Method Orange in the finals. Colo being targeted down by Roasties, and this is maybe a standard strategy for the Rogue Mage Druid, perhaps his Arcane, if Jamili can spell steal the heal over time effects, and then Rub Cub can add some extra damage with the Feral Affinity. Maybe that's the strategy they're looking to employ?
Oh, I guess, yeah, Rub Cub on the Restoration Druid. The thing is, I don't actually know if Arcane is better. I mean, in theory, you have a lot of spell steals, you have a lot of mobility to get around, but the one thing you lack is the control on the melee. So you don't have as many roots, as many Novas for Valido, for Zach to have to sit through, and it allows him to have more uptime on Rub Cub, which means more mana rifts on Rub Cub, which means less mana for Rub Cub. And I don't know if they're going to have enough time to actually train down Colo in this matchup.
I mean, they're also pressuring Rub Cub away, and as Feral Affinity, sure, he adds a lot of damage, but he also takes a lot more damage. So it's a double-edged sword in this specific matchup, as both teams seem to be going after each other's healers. Colo stunned up, Jamili continuing to spell steal heal over time effects. Good pressure on Colo. Ironbark has faded. He's got Barkskin. He doesn't want to use it until he's stunned, so he's in a tough decision here. If he uses it now, then when he gets stunned later on, he likely has to use the Glider's Medallion, but he's managed to hold on and not have to use it. Jamili, maybe he's a little bit too close for comfort, taking quite a bit of pressure, but he needs to be there to spell steal the heal over time effects to support Roasties. Rub Cub somehow has to navigate away with a Demon Hunter chasing him down the whole game to actually attack Colo. If Rub Cub doesn't add in the extra damage, I do not think that they will kill him. Now we do see Rub Cub making a push, but Jamili is stunned. And I like that they stun Jamili while Colo is stunned, so he can't spell steal all the heal over time effects during it, and he will receive some amount of healing. I would say, so far so good for Never Lucky. They have the Darkness for the next attack, and Iron Park a Trinket. Their defense is looking solid, and it's Rub Cub who is falling behind right now.
Yeah, Rub Cub's in a little bit of trouble. Might have to play defensive, and that is not the situation you really want to be in. You know, in theory, the Arcane Mage is great. You have a lot of spell steals for Colo, but the problem is, if you're just spamming out spell steal, you're not doing damage. Whereas the Frost Mage, he has the Kleptomania honor talent they normally run, and then you drop your Frozen Orb, and it just pairs really nicely with every single Kidney Shot. That being said, M2KC, they are finding some pressure here. Darkness does get dropped out there by Zach to back up Colo. You can see Colo, he still has his Ironbark, he still has his Trinket, but Rub Cub, he's been managing to hold on to his mana, and this is actually looking pretty good for M2KC.
Yeah, he got Darkness out of the way. Next Vendetta, that won't be available. Colo is being pressured. Momentum swinging in favor of M2KC. This all-in strategy to kill the Druid with Spell Steal appears to be finally working here for M2KC, and if this is a strategy that works, perhaps it's one they can employ against Method Orange in the final, should they make it all the way through. Never Lucky here in the lower bracket, best of five. It's an elimination round. The loser of this goes home in third place. There's a lot of points on the line, especially considering that Cloud9 has already qualified, so their points effectively don't matter to the North American teams. They're competing with the second place point earners, which is currently the boys, and the boys didn't make it nearly this far. We've got Method Orange, Never Lucky, M2KC, which are right behind them on their tails, all competing with each other to get points to pass them. So if you're the boys, you're cheering for a team to beat Method Orange because they're currently the highest.
Wow.
Right now. Pressure is still very high on Colo. Seems like they're switching their attention to Roasties more, and maybe that should be the priority. Get the Rogue off of the Druid, but it does look difficult for Never Lucky to get momentum going for themselves.
Yeah, this is looking really good for M2KC. They're doing a great job, great adaptation during this tournament, and they're actually going after Colo. Roasties could be in a little bit of trouble, though. He gets caught into the stun. Evasion and Cloak of Shadows gets traded out, overlapped with Ironbark. So basically, Roasties and M2KC has committed every single one of their defensives, but Colo's on the defensive right now. He's in a lot of trouble. There's not too many defensive cooldowns left. Zach, Valido, they can't help him out. There's no anti-magic zone. There's no darkness. Beautiful cross crowd control coming in from M2KC. A nice setup here on a Colo. He preemptively uses the Ironbark to stay alive, but once that fades, there's nothing left.
Yeah, and there's Vendetta. It's available right now. Roasties can pull the trigger on that as soon as he wants to, and he's going to right now. Rub Cub needs to add some damage, and he is. This is exactly the situation that M2KC need to close the game. There's still no answers for quite some time. 14 seconds away. Just stay on target and find the kill. Do whatever you have to do. There's still a window of time. 8 seconds away for Kolo to be able to survive. He stuns Rub Cub. He stalls the Feral Affinity. He makes his moves around the corner. Roasties is still on target, but now with Barkskin available and Kolo having recovered, the opportunity is lost, and now Never Lucky have a second chance to take a kill here onto Roasties very shortly.
Yep, Zach trying to stay on target. He needs to land those mana rifts onto Rub Cub. The thing is, Rub Cub, he has been getting rifted down. His mana's not looking great, and for the first time, he's really had to run away in this matchup. Valido unfortunately can't stay on target. Rub Cub just charges in, trying to continue the damage over onto Kolo, but Kolo's been doing a good job. He has the trinket rotating back up, as well as his renewal and Iron Bark. I really feel like what M2KC, this strategy, would work for them. I think if Jamili was Frost, they'd have the little bit of extra damage that they needed. I think this could have been a great job. Rosie's falling apart a little bit. Rub Cub falling apart as well. And M2KC ultimately falls, but I think this is a really good sign. On as long as possible, land mana rifts on Rub Cub as many times as you can. And eventually, Rub Cub runs out of mana. We saw Roasties fall in the last game, but there was pressure all over the place. I was impressed by the way Kolo kind of handled himself in that last game. He's playing Renewal right now, so he knows in this matchup he's the target of choice. Maybe M2KC, they go after someone else, but I just feel like that would be a big mistake.
All right, let's see if they can do it here. Not running the Kleptomania talent, so Jamili's damage is going to be very low. Never Lucky actually focusing down the mage was a bit surprising. You don't usually see the Arcane Mage as the target. M2KC, they're going all out. They're going straight for Kolo. I think this is the right strategy, although perhaps maybe they can make the Arcane work, but I also agree, why not just play what has worked for other teams? Run the Frost specialization, run the Kleptomania, and then play the same strategies that have been working for other teams. Of course, they could be Trailblazers. Of course, they could set their own meta and their own counter, and they may just very well do that. They've been working one by one through the cooldowns of Kolo, but now Never Lucky look to counter engage. There's good pressure on Rub Cub, and on Hook Point, there really isn't anywhere to run. Rub Cub is trying to make it away, but he's under so much fire right now, perhaps just going down at the first stages of the fight. Multiple Gladiators, Maledicts. Rub Cub in a lot of trouble. Jamili trying to play support, but there's too much damage. Rub Cub's being overwhelmed. They've managed to stall it just long enough. Amazing teamwork from Jamili and Roasties to keep Rub Cub alive in that dire situation.
Yeah, really beautiful gameplay there by Jamili and Roasties, saving Rub Cub in a very dire situation. Just heads up overall. Never Lucky now. They have to focus on defense, keeping Kolo alive. Kolo has to get out of line of sight, making sure he's trying to avoid as many spell steals as possible, as much of that Arcane Mage damage as he possibly can. For Jamili, it's a different story. He has to make sure he's controlling Valido, controlling Zach, trying to limit those mana rifts. But when Rub Cub's playing aggressive like this, this is when we want to see Never Lucky make these attempts on Rub Cub, and he's really vulnerable. Keep in mind, he's playing Relentless. He has no way to get out of crowd control. Barskin's now just rotated back up, but we saw Never Lucky almost shred through both of those defensives.
Yeah, we did. Now, though, Rub Cub will have those as answers, and I'm curious if that means that he's going to get aggressive. He needs to. They need that extra Feral Affinity damage, so Rub Cub has to take the risk to go into cat form and attack. Otherwise, they don't have enough damage to kill Kolo, but he needs to do it while still keeping himself alive. So this is the difficulty of running that Feral Affinity. And of course, we know Rub Cub for phenomenal Holy Paladin play, so switching over to this Restoration Druid will be quite a challenge. And perhaps maybe it isn't ready today, but if they can focus on grinding it up and getting it to the same level of that of maybe Grekki or Cubsy, then this is the answer. This is what they can bring to defeat the Demon Hunter Death Knight composition. Otherwise, I mean, they went 0-9 in spring and could have qualified if they beat it one time in one series. Now they're almost about to go 0-6, so they've really got to put it together. There's been more than enough time. They've got to get the games, pick a composition that has been run by other teams, whether it be the Mage Warlock Druid or the Frost Rogue Mage Druid, or maybe even a Windwalker Mage composition, something. Pick it, focus on it, grind it, because this is the only thing that's stopping them. They're owning teams like Cloud9. They're owning Cloud9, but they can't beat some of the lesser ranked teams in point standings. What, just because they have a Death Knight? I mean, it's been so long and other teams can beat them. They can do it. They have the capability. If they lose this, I want to see Jamili switch to Frost. If they win it, then perhaps I'll just eat my words. They can keep playing it through and this will be their answer, but there is certainly an answer.
I mean, There's no doubt about it. This composition has sort of fell off in the entire European region. I don't think we saw Demon Hunter Death Knight played at all during the spring finals. Right now, Jamili's using a lot of mana, spamming out Arcane Blast, switching his attention over to Valido. And I don't know, Sid, do you feel like making a switch over on the Death Knight is the right answer? I mean, Kolo really hasn't been under any pressure in this game whatsoever. Now, finally, they're going after Valido, potentially trying to switch it up, but I just don't know if that is the winning strategy.
I mean, at this point, it looks like they're just trying to feel it out, see what happens. Maybe it works. So
Maybe.
Far, right now, they've got good damage on Valido. Nice swap. Kolo is struggling. Valido doesn't have runic power, so he cannot use Death Strike, but a big Swift Man from Kolo will stabilize him from now and allow him to recover. I'm curious what the mana situation is. This is evenly fought so far in terms of cooldowns, but if Rub Cub is out of mana, then it's pretty much dire straits for M2KC. He's not. He's actually at a mana advantage over that of Neverlucky, so there is potential here. Although maybe they should have gone for a map where they can set up drinks and then maybe a kill on the Death Knight and Dampening, something like that. Could have honestly worked for them, but right now on hook point, they're not doing the all-in on hook point, so the map pick is potentially going to backfire on them.
Yeah, Valido still under fire. Jamili just spamming out the spell steals. Some big arcane missiles connecting. Kolo's really struggling to heal through this. Kolo's actually behind on mana at this point, and maybe going after Valido, spamming out spell steal, making Kolo consistently apply those heal over time effects. It's a strategy M2KC can sort of run Neverlucky out of mana first, but I'm not convinced just yet. Bash over onto Kolo. Valido trinkets out. Anti-magic zone gets traded out. And Rub Cub now getting mana rifted by Zac once again. Asphyxiate and Chaos Nova get traded out. Rub Cub, 20% mana. You can bet there's not going to be much of an opportunity in this game for him to really escape, get out of combat, and go for a drink. So what the mana he has now, he really has to make work. They have to deny Zac on some of these mana rifts.
All right, let's see if they can do it. Kolo's blinded with no trinket. This is the push. This is the opportunity in the moment, and they get denied. Zac is there to save the day. Darkness is down. Valido will take zero damage as a result. That was the one moment where they maybe could have snuck in a kill, but they get denied by Zac. Good cooldown management so far from Neverlucky. A solid defense on their part here facing M2KC. Rub Cub is slowly but surely getting tapped on mana, and at some point, I don't think he's ever going to get a drink, certainly not on hook point. They polymorph up Zac to try and deny the mana rift. Kolo's now stunned. Rub Cub looks for crowd control. Not going to be able to get it, but they get polymorph instead. That forces anti-magic shield. There has been decent damage on Valido. Surprisingly, I see potential in this strategy, but not for at least another 20-25% dampening.
Does Rub Cub have that much time? I mean, that's the real question. He's on 15% mana. He's been able to avoid some of these mana rifts. Honestly, I feel like Valido and Zac could be doing a little bit better of a job. Rubka's been able to escape a little bit. It's tricky when you have Relentless, but still, Valido now in a kidney shot. Kolo gets the Iron Bark off. That will be enough to keep Valido alive. But like you said, Sid, the strategy, it's working out okay. Kolo and Rubka, they're basically even on mana. I think Valido and Zac, they've been focusing their attention more on Jamili now, trying to limit some of these arcane missiles he's been able to spam out. The thing is, every time you use Spell Steal as an arcane mage, it gives you an opportunity to get basically clear casting proc, which empowers your arcane missiles and does really, really good damage. So if you can sort of shut down those arcane missiles, the arcane mage single target damage is going to be significantly lower. And I think Valido and Zac have realized he's kind of a threat of being allowed to free cast missiles, but when they're on top of them with their ranged interrupts, it severely limits the damage output for M2KC.
All right, significant mana advantage for Neverlucky at this point in time, which is very devastating, because if they keep doing this Death Knight strategy, they're going to at least need 35% dampening. So they're mixing it up. They're going after a different target. Zac's getting bursted. Kolo's in a polymorph. Reverse magic available. Zac gets over there, tags Kolo out of crowd control. Rub Cub moves in. What's he going to try and do? It doesn't look like anything. He just walks in and gets crowd controlled. Actually, just mana rifted again. That should be the remainder of his mana. Jamili's getting pressured. He's going to have to ice block. Overlapped with Iron Bark. Defensive M2KC is totally shattered and blown out at this point. I do anticipate Neverlucky to be walking away with this shortly. And when we move to a game number three, perhaps M2KC could run this strategy on a bigger map where Rub Cub can drink if they want to do it, or maybe make a change to Frost and try and run a setup that is very similar to what Europe has been running to deal with this. But even if the Frost Rogue Druid works, what if Neverlucky just plays a different composition to beat that? They would have to beat them outright in a reverse sweep on their counter pick and their counter map. Jamili's in so much trouble at this point. Rub Cub just doesn't have anything to work with. The damage is too overwhelming. Neverlucky take game two.
Yeah, never lucky, clean and precise in their victory once again.
So long.
That's not true, because they did beat the boys.
Okay, they beat the boys. But the boys didn't run the Demon Hunter Death Knight. They were in the Windwalker Death
Knight. They sure did.
They did.
They beat them as beat them.
What does that say about... Okay, we're not firing any more shots. We're not firing any more shots.
Speak for yourself.
All right, so Rosita Jones, we were wondering what he was going to be used for. We saw him on the Death Knight a little bit earlier, and I guess for the Frostmage specialization is going to be his role on the roster, or at least one of them. Have Roasties on the Assassination Rogue, Rub Cub on the Restoration Druid, and it's going to be a Colo race down once again. Rosita Jones blinking in, drops the Frozen Orb. Big Bash coming in as well from Rub Cub. Already outstanding pressure. A lot of damage. Colo already commits a Shadow Melt. Rosita Jones blinking in. And it's all about these consistent setups. Every time there's a kidney shot from Roasties, Rosita Jones can dump all of his damage, get a Kleptomania spell steal, and keep just Novas. The most powerful crowd control Rosita Jones has in this matchup is just his Pet Freeze and his Frost Nova. Those two abilities are just going to snare up Zac and Valido and make it difficult for them to really help out Colo in these moments where they're swapped to him.
Rosita's doing a great job so far using Blizzard to try and reset that Frozen Orb cooldown for the next burst attempt. Ray of Frost during the Stunlock combo. Andy Magic Zone, a very good cooldown in this position to negate the Icy Veins and Vendetta of M2KC, but it may not be enough on its own. Colo still hovering at half health, perhaps requiring the darkness as well. The pressure of M2KC is quite high at this moment in time. Rub Cub doing a great job maintaining his own health so he can be aggressive. It's all about Rub Cub. He needs to add extra damage to the team without going down himself. If he can manage to navigate both offense and defense, of course, with support from Rosita, then I do think M2KC are capable of overcoming the slump against Demon Hunter Death Knight. I do believe.
Yep, Frozen Orb on top of that kidney shot, and this is the very powerful combo. Rosita Jones trinkets out of the imprisonment into a stun, but Cole's in a lot of trouble. He's used his Barkskin. He might have to activate the renewal. He does. The only thing he has left is the trinket, but M2KC, they might be able to take him down with just raw damage. Zac still has the darkness, might have to trade that out shortly. Colo finally out of the woods for a little bit, but not completely yet. Needs to get out of line of sight. Rosita Jones able to just spam out Frostbolts right now. This is not ideal positioning. Colo kind of just ran back in Rosita Jones' line of sight, allowing him to get some damage out. Colo in a little bit of trouble, but all three members of M2KC are rotting down as well.
All right. Can Rub Cub hold on long enough? They've been getting pretty close to getting a kill on Colo. They're on match point, and I mean, if they could manage to pull off a victory in this cup, then they can bounce ahead in the standings significantly above Never Lucky, at least. Maybe get etched a bit closer to Method Orange and potentially be able to qualify later in the year to the World Finals on point. So there's a lot on the line, even though this is just the first cup of the summer season. Pressure has been high so far from M2KC. Mana is still reasonably even, but Colo has Barkskin for the next attack, Darkness for the one after that. So there is going to still have to be a few more attempts. Rub Cub on the big map, which I like. The big map.
Ooh, nice blind.
Drink. Yeah, but I believe the Ursul's Vortex. Okay, so Rub Cub smartly. So Ursul's Vortex puts you in combat, but you instantly drop combat, even though the effect is still on you. So Rub Cub just sat down and drank again instantly. He didn't fall for the bait of trying to move out of it and then avoid it. Rub Cub was able to regenerate mana as a result of the blind. And I like this map pick. I like the strategy that they're going for. If there was a game for M2KC to beat a DK, this is the game.
I mean, this is looking really good for M2KC. This is kind of how you'd expect this matchup to play out. Colo has been doing a good job surviving these swaps so far. He has Renewal rotating back up. They need to find a stun with no Barkskin and no Trinket. If they can find that outside of Bear Form, it's going to be danger time for Mr. Colo. And we'll have to see if they're able to find it. Roasties does manage to find a kidney shot. Large damage once again. There's the Frozen Orb. Rosita Jones, how much more damage do you have? Can they take down Colo? Zac and Valido still trying to create pressure on Rosita Jones. And I have to feel for Rosita Jones in this matchup. Although his job is to just crowd control of Zac and Valido and get burst damage out, they're not making it easy for him. Keeping Chains of Ice up the entire time. Death gripping him away every single time he shimmers in and tries to get some significant damage out. And that's one of the reasons why Colo's been able to survive, is Rosita Jones hasn't been able to get out that much damage because he's always out of line of sight, always gripped away, always in Chains of Ice. It's really going to be up to him to make sure he can get that crowd control out before he goes for these shimmer all-in damage plays.
Roasty's getting swapped too. Rosita Jones getting softened up as well. Two members of the team, low health, but Rub Cub needs to do damage as well if they want to push Colo over. If they want to stay alive in the tournament, they have to do it three games in a row. against Never Lucky. And even though I said that the momentum was looking in their favor, Colo's defense is solid to the point where I'm not sure. It's still quite a ways away until I see an opening for them to get a kill. They catch Colo out of bear form. That is a good opportunity to strike, and they get two cooldowns as a result. He's still not in bear form. Potentially, they get all of the defensive cooldowns, and they can keep their tournament dreams alive. Big mistakes here, getting caught out of form and still in a lot of trouble. Darkness available, but they would like to save it for Vendetta. Colo has to make it out of this on his own. He needs to make his own way. He's managed to do it. He survived, but really, at what cost? I mean, that was Iron Bark, that was Barkskin, that was Trinket. If Zac gets crowd controlled on the next attack on Colo, I think it's lights out.
It definitely could be. He's in bear form. He wants to be able to dispel Zac right now, but they're making it difficult. Roasties was out of line of sight, so Colo could safely get that dispel and get back into bear form without the threat of the Kidney Shot and Caster, which would have been a complete disaster. Colo now in bear form in Kidney Shot, and Prismic gets cast out onto Roasties. Rosita Jones under fire. Good damage. Rubcub's mana is falling a little bit behind. I think Colo is actually below his mana at this point. It's actually relatively even, so no major differences there. Zeta Jones channeling out a Ray of Frost, getting that damage out on Colo that he really needs. His next stun on Colo could be devastating.
Oh, Rosita Jones forced into an ice block, finally some pressure there for Never Lucky, and that is going to be very difficult for Rubcub now. He has to heal knowing that he's down cooldowns while still attacking and maximizing his damage. Otherwise, they're not going to have enough to push Colo over. And despite that play earlier and mistake on Colo's part, his defense is now all available, all up and ready. Rubcub needs a drink. There's no way that they can play this out with the current mana state of Rubcub, but they're going for it. They're trying to find a kill. Perhaps they make a mistake. Perhaps they choke. That could be an opportunity. They've got good damage right now on Colo. Kidney Shot into Bash. Icy Veins is blowing this out right now. Huge damage, but Colo's holding on. No Darkness, and Zach's holding that in his back pocket for a counter push. Darkness, the most powerful defensive cooldown on the team. Zac needs to be on top of the target he wants to use it on because it's dropped in melee range. It's a purple cloud on the ground that effectively makes 70% of all incoming attacks miss. There is a 30% chance that you can die, but I don't think we've ever actually seen a game where that 30% actually killed somebody. Of course, I could be commentator cursing it right now, but there's good pressure on Colo. Rubcub is able to maximize his damage. Zac needs to help, I believe. Colo's making it out with Frenzied Regeneration, gets back in his Efflorescence, but it is likely that Darkness will be required soon as Dampening gets higher.
Uh-oh. Colo's still in a lot of trouble. Roasty's Rubcub, they're all over him. Is there any extra damage? Darkness gets dropped out by Zac. Is this it? Can M2KC stay in this series, stay in the tournament? Colo gets caught into a Kidney Shot. He trinkets out into a Bash. Nicely done by Rubcub. Roasty's all over him. Garrote Silence. Is there any more damage? Rubcub has to get aggressive right here, right now with Roasty's. Colo completely on the ropes. Barkskin, Iron Bark, all traded out. He's got no mana left. They are just barely at the finish line. Colo is in so much trouble.
All right, Colo, what are you going to do? You're on the ropes. You got no mana. Dampening's high up here in the sky. Vendetta's rolling. Roasties is maxed out on his damage. You're fully stunned. There's no defense. All he can do is try his best to heal with nothing. They stun up Rosita. They stun up Roasties. They try and stop the damage, but I'm sure that it is not going to stop anytime soon. Colo in so much trouble. You know what the advice is, Jamili? Bring in Rosita Jones. That's the advice.
Rosita Jones, the wild
card. That looked easy.
From BlizzCon 2017. Absolutely.
Limits, raise up the power level of North America just so that Zico's disappointed.
Achievement unlocked, blue skies, blue sunny skies, no cloud nine for both of these teams. You know, Never Lucky right now. They are just one game away from sending M2KC out of this tournament. This is a matchup that I would say they are favored in, but you know, with how M2KC played out that last game, definitely options here for them, and they are going to be going after Colo very early on. Kidney Shot, Life Cocoon, Transcendence Portal just a meter away. I don't know. Colo, he needs to get that Transcendence in a little bit better of a position. He does manage to survive, but he's in a kind of an awkward spot right now.
Yeah, he definitely is. Chains of Ice, though, pinning Roasties. Shadow steps over, Ring of Peace knocks Roasties away, blinds Colo. Now his team has time to catch up, but they're under pressure. Never Lucky, they're going after Rubcub. They're going straight for the healer. How is Rubcub going to deal with it? He's able to wild charge to safety. Rosita Jones has got good control of Zac and Valido. I want to credit Rosita Jones on that. He has two members attacking him the whole game, but he is able to crowd control them and then get to the target exactly when he needs to be able to do damage. So under the pressure is certainly not cracking. Now they need to try and get back to Colo, waiting for that grapple weapon to fade so Roasties can stun. He shadow steps over. Colo Transcendence is the shadow step. Roasties moving in with that maneuverability honor talent, so he's not snared. He connects. Can Rosita Jones close the gap? Can Rubcub get there? Is Rubcub running Feral Affinity is then the next big question. Otherwise, he's not going to be able to add any extra damage. He may have gone the safe route and gone for the Guardian Affinity so that he doesn't need to worry about being all-in'd on. Kolo, he's popping away at the Crane. He's punching away at Rub Cub. Both healers are definitely not afraid to go at each other. Rub Cub very low health, trying to jump to safety, gets knocked off the side. Shadow melts the Gladiator's Maledict, but all three members of Neverlucky are closing in. At the same time, M2KC go after Kolo. They get his Gladiator's Medallion and Life Cocoon. Opportunity later on to kill Kolo. M2KC looks solid so far.
Yeah, M2KC looking solid. Kolo was in a little bit of trouble. He's traded out so many of his defensive cooldowns. There's no revival, there's no fortifying brew, no anything really. So all he really has to rely on is that Transcendence Portal, and I think you can see it in the midfield. Rosita actually lands an interrupt right now. Rosita Jones and Rub Cub, they have to get on top of Kolo. They need to start doing damage. Rosita Jones is positioned so far away. Kolo's been kiting, getting away from Rosita Jones, and that's basically been his objective this entire game. Just create space between him and Rosita Jones so that Frostmage really can't get out any sort of significant damage. Kolo shuts down the drink from Rub Cub, but it doesn't really matter. Rub Cub was able to recover that mana, and that actually gives M2KC a lead in this matchup.
All right, M2KC in a solid position. Good attack here engaged onto Kolo, potentially taking us to a game five, potentially taking us for a reverse sweep. We're going to have to wait and see. And I mean, if they manage to pull it off, they might have a decent answer then for Method Orange in the finals. And perhaps this will not be a Method-only championship this weekend. Rosita being bursted down, gripping a double stun. Solid setup from Neverlucky as they look to reverse the pressure. Another stun followed up, but Kolo is overextended. He did activate the Fortifying Brew before moving in, so he anticipated that he would be attacked when he moved to midfield. Activated his defense before the attack. Stayed alive as a result. Now he can be aggressive, potentially net an ice block. It was a good play on Kolo's part, but Cycloned at low health, so Rub Cub equally countering it.
Yeah, Kolo getting a little bit low. He used the Way of the Crane. There was a defensive blind that came out of Roasty, so you can tell the strategy that M2KC is wanting to implement. It's all about control on Valido, control on Zac, limit their damage output, allow Rub Cub to not have to use too much mana, and just go after Kolo consistently, over and over. Put Roasties on top of Kolo, basically an attack dog, just chasing him down the entire game. And when Rosita Jones, when Rub Cub can connect damage, that's going to be gravy. But for now, Rosita Jones and Rub Cub, they just have to try to stay alive while Roasties is just continuously doing work on Kolo.
All right, let's see if Roasties can get something going here onto Kolo. They need to work their way through that Glider's Medallion. Maybe make a switch and try and bait a trinket on Blind, something along these lines. Although it's likely they could use Blind to maybe bait Zach's trinket and try and kill Zach later on. That could be an option as well for the Rogue Mage setup. Roasties is being pummeled down at the moment by Neverlucky and has to use Evasion. He's on the run. Valido's been getting a couple of cheeky Dark Simulacrums as well on Rosita Jones's Polymorph. So Rosita definitely wants to be careful with that ability. If Valido steals a Polymorph and is able to use that on Rub Cub to prevent him from healing, that could be an ice block out of Rosita's back pocket. Roasties getting Kolo's trinket with Rosita's frozen orbs, or not getting the trinket, sorry, getting the life cocoon from Kolo. One cooldown out of the way. Every kidney shot needs to be a cooldown if M2KC want to pull off victory, but Rub Cub, Rosita, they're stacked up together. They're taking a beating. Rub Cub catches a Swiftman. Kolo's getting a lot of, I would actually say that Kolo's getting more value out of Way of the Crane than we even saw Looney, but the disadvantage is that it's very expensive, so Kolo could run out of mana if he chooses to keep using the Way of the Crane as frequently as he is. Rub Cub's crowd controlled. Rosita's the target. He's going to respect the damage, trade the ice block for the Touch of Death, a fair trade, not wanting to gamble it. They're on match point.
Yeah, Kolo with another Transcendence, Ring of Peace, Roasties off the edge, and Melito's been doing a really good job keeping the chains of ice on Roasties, on Rosita Jones, making sure their mobility is severely limited in this matchup. Kolo gets interrupted. What is he going to do? Into a kidney shot, pre-fortifying brew. That's going to keep him alive, but a big setup here from M2KC. Kolo has to get out of line of sight. One Maledict connects. Kolo rolls away out of line of sight. Rosita Jones with a nice blink, though. Kolo does Transcendence back. Roasty's trying to reconnect, and I think Kolo's actually playing the short Transcendence cooldown in this matchup so we can get away from Rosita, or from Roasty's and Rosita Jones more often. Not 100% sure on that just yet. 5% dampening as we march forward. If we look at mana, Kolo still has a lead. I'm not sure if Rub Cub's really going to be able to escape. I mean, Rosita Jones, he's down one ice block. He's got one left. Is it going to be worth it, Sid, for him to trade that out for Rub Cub to really sit down for a drink?
Be a risky move, but I mean, you've got no mana, it's game over anyway. I think mana should be more valuable, and they should probably do it now while Ironbark is active, but not looking like they're sneaking away for it. Instead, trying to set up maybe to punch through and kill Kolo. Kolo's had some pretty good predictions in terms of the attacks from M2KC so far. I haven't seen any sort of significant holes in his defensive game plan so far, but if he even makes one error, he will be going down and we'll be moving to a game number five here in the lower bracket. Both these teams facing elimination in our second to last series of the day. We've gone through Europe. Method Black took that. Now in North America, Method Orange looks solid, but between both Neverlucky and M2KC, they are improving drastically, even just within this series alone.
Yeah, I mean, it's looking good for them. Kolo under fire once again. Here's the thing about this particular matchup. In the meantime, actually, Rosita getting bursted down. Is he going to be able to survive? He uses the temporal shield. Should be able to bounce back to full. But here's the thing about this particular matchup is early on, the Rogue Mage Druid, you don't have many good targets. You kind of are forced to go after the Mistweaver, play out sort of a long, drawn-out strategy of just controlling up Zac, controlling up Valido. But as the game goes on, as dampening gets higher, all of a sudden, the Death Knight is self-healing just is limited so much. You can go after the Death Knight. He's a great target. And Rosita Jones, Rosie's and RevCup, they can switch up their strategy, keep Neverlucky guessing, and go after that Death Knight.
All right, perhaps that could be the move. If they've got mana, Death Knights do die. We saw that earlier with Zpy on his Death Knight going down. So M2KC need to realize that if that situation arises when they get to the 30, 40% dampening mark, I think they should go for the mana, go for that play, go for the safe kill on the Death Knight in dampening, because so far they've looked solid trying to kill Kolo, but they could mix it up, catch him off guard, and then advance to a game number five, although they will have to fight on another small map in this specific matchup, which is looking more like maybe a 55-45, if that's even correct math. Another Dark Simulacrum Poly. These are the ones that could cost Rosita's Ice Block, and they want to trade Ice Block for mana, not for crowd control that was stolen, but they're going to have to trade it for crowd control that was stolen. Roasties is trying to carry in this position, going after Kolo in the back line, but with Way of the Crane active, unlikely to find the kill, and Kolo is going to be able to punch Roasties back and away, likely. Although the defense is cracking on both sides, mana is becoming increasingly limited. Although I'd say that there's
ooh, this is big.
The Death and Decay missed. How much? He got full mana.
This is best case scenario for M2KC. 22% dampening. RubCup completely resets his mana. Here's an opportunity. What is Roasties going to do? Is he just going to train down Kolo for the rest of the game?
Oh, no.
Are they going to try to play a little bit more safe?
Oh, no.
Rosita Jones in so much trouble! And he gets taken down. A nice off-interrupt with the pet of Valido. That is so devastating for M2KC. They were so close.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.